gentlemen, we're out here. It's only about 90 today, which is cool for our area. And we're on the backside of the Perris Castle. Now, there is said to be paranormal activity, so what we're gonna do is we're gonna try to follow around the backside of the castle and get a view that they're not really wanting us to get. And we're gonna see if we can see these supposed hidden chambers. Dangerous up here, rattlesnake country. It's also, we look over here, the gang marking, it's gang territory too. Originally built in 1928, and I think the stones were hauled in from Riverside, if I have that correct, or Whitewater, and maybe through the river, Riverside. I'm getting close to the peak. What we want to do is see if we can get a look here. It is coming into view of the backside of the castle. There is a good view of the castle.
So, is it true that Vincent Price actually used to live here?
That's what the rumor says. That this was one of his getaways. Hollywood would come out there in Lake Elsinore, then he'd come up here and hold seances.
Really?
I wanna ride
We're at the very peak here, overlooking the Perris Castle from the back side. You can see in the background, there's Idlewild mountain range on one side. Perris Valley unfolds in front of us. Over there is Big Bear mountain range. Nowadays, the Perris Castle is owned by the
Hexdale family. And the house is 4,000 square feet. Has walls that are 6 feet thick. Has a huge wine cellar. Was built for $75,000 in 1928-29. And was sold during the Depression for $6,500.